This video was produced to train field biologists and technicians to successfully complete willow flycatcher surveys, which follow a standardized protocol. The following presentation will help you identify willow flycatcher habitat and assist you in recognizing their vocalizations. This protocol only addresses two of the three subspecies of willow flycatchers which occur in California: Empidonax trailii brewsteri and Empidonax trailii adastis. The willow flycatcher, Empidonax trailii, is a small neotropical bird which depends upon wet meadow habitat to breed. Willow flycatchers are a very rare bird in the state of California. The bird is a Region 5 U.S. Forest Service sensitive species and is listed as an endangered species by the state of California. The southwestern willow flycatcher was federally listed as an endangered species in 1995.
In California, three subspecies of the willow flycatcher occur: Empidonax trailii brewsteri, which occurs along the western side of the Sierra Nevada and Cascades; Empidonax trailii adastis, which occurs at higher elevations in the Sierra Nevada and down the eastern slope of the Sierra Nevadas; and Empidonax trailii extremis, the southwestern willow flycatcher, which occurs from the Kern River south. This training video and the accompanying survey protocol are only to be used when surveying for brewsteri and adastis. The southwestern willow flycatcher has a separate survey protocol.
Most of the remaining populations of willow flycatchers occur in mountain meadows. The largest known population occurs along segments of the Little Truckee River, with the most notable occurrence at Parazo Meadows. Habitat typically includes wet meadows with perennial streams or smaller spring-fed areas with willows. The presence of standing water or saturated soils during the breeding season is a very important habitat component.
Willow flycatchers have also been found in riparian habitats of various types and sizes, ranging from small lakes or ponds surrounded by willows to willow-lined streams, grasslands, or swampy areas. The minimum meadow size usable for willow flycatchers is assumed to be 0.6 acres. Willow flycatchers generally nest in clumps of willows at least 5 to 6 feet tall in the vicinity of standing water. Nests are open-cupped, usually 1 to 1.5 meters above the ground, and mostly near the edge of willow clumps. Nests are often placed in the fork of a branch with the nest cup supported by several small diameter stems. There are reports of willow flycatchers nesting in other shrubs such as alder.
The willow flycatcher is a small bird, approximately 15 centimeters long and weighing about 11 to 12 grams. Sexes look alike and cannot be distinguished by plumage. The upper parts are brownish olive, a white throat contrasts with the pale olive breast, and the belly is pale yellow. Two pale wing bars are visible. Juveniles have buffy wing bars, but are not highly prominent. From a distance, one of the most notable plumage characteristics is the contrast between the dark crown and pale whitish chin and throat. The area around the eye, called the eye ring, is a common diagnostic feature in Empidonax flycatchers. In the willow flycatcher, the eye ring is faint or absent. Overall, the bill is very wide and relatively long, giving it a larger appearance than other Empidonax flycatchers.
When perched, the willow flycatcher often flicks its tail upward. The Empidonax flycatchers are a difficult group of birds to distinguish by appearance. Typical flycatcher behavior includes perching and singing from an exposed branch. From here, the willow flycatcher will fly out from the branch to catch insects. This is a very common behavior for flycatchers, often referred as the bird flies out and back from its perch. Given that willow Empidonax flycatchers, vocalizations are a critical identifier. The survey protocol which we discuss depends ultimately upon identifying the willow flycatcher by its vocalizations.
The best way to identify willow flycatchers is by listening for the Fitzbue song. And for the purposes of this protocol, you need to hear the Fitzbue song to positively identify a bird as a willow flycatcher. The reason for this is that many other birds sound and look like willow flycatchers. Western wood pewees and dusky flycatchers, as well as Hammond's flycatchers, are very similar in appearance and are often impossible to tell apart from a distance. And then in addition, dusky flycatchers, being closely related to willow flycatchers, have many clues, including their whit call.
Let's listen now to the Fitzbue. Now to the whit call. The primary objective of the survey protocol is survey technique to detect willow flycatchers and provide consistent. This protocol is intended to determine presence or absence of willow flycatchers. It does not address with nest monitoring or other research. The use by people who are not Pedonax flycatchers and who. However, surveyors must experience with bird identification and surveys to distinguish from other Pedonax species. Be prepared to work hard and remain focused in physically demanding conditions. This may include very cold mornings, muddy or swampy conditions.
To complete willow flycatching requires some pre-work. Habitat is identified based on definitions. Once an area is identified as suitable habitat, the project leader 1000 USGS map and delineate the. In addition to outlining the area on a map, the area should also be delineated on a survey area is outlined. Surveyors should visit the survey is conducted, if possible. By doing so, we are with identifying the willow flycatchers in the field. This will give the crew lead to identify any potential barriers, which may not allow you to put survey points. Survey points should be spaced at a maximum meters for large open meadow settings and 30 meters for areas with tall and or areas with high levels of stream noise that may impair. If you don't know how long your pace is, take a tape measure into the field as it takes you to walk 10 meters. Divide 10 by the number of steps and the length of your stride. Because willow flycatchers require shrubbing, avoid survey efforts in the open areas with no shrub components. Points included in the survey should be numbered on the aerial photo or map, and the survey protocol requires two mandatory visits at each may occur between June 15th and June 25th. The other mandatory visit may occur either between June 1st and 14th or June 26th through July 15th. Always take time to be careful when completing field surveys. Surveyors on a clipboard, a portable cassette player with a portable megaphone to broadcast the willow flycatcher vocalizations, a tape of the willow flycatcher vocalizations, which is listed in the protocol, extra batteries, pens, bird field guide, hip waders or rubber boots, wet, and a radio or cell phone in case of an emergency. A camera is always nice to have along to document habitat and survey efforts. They are attached to the protocol.
Before each survey, the crew should conduct the job hazard analysis, identifying any potential hazards they may encounter while surveying.
Begin surveys early in the morning, as soon as there is enough light to safely walk, about 1 hour before sunrise, and end the survey by 10 a.m. Surveys should not be conducted during times of steady rain or wind. Conduct surveys from as close to the shrubby vegetation as possible without breaking or damaging the vegetation. It is advisable to pace off 30 to 50 meters between points. Sometimes it is difficult to hear the vocalizations amidst other noises. The observer will start at a survey point at one end of the survey area. The observer will stand quietly and listen for flycatchers for 10 minutes. If willow flycatchers are heard, then complete the survey form and record the bird's location on your map. Be sure to determine how many birds are singing. Sometimes you may have more than one bird respond.
If no birds are detected through the initial listening period, broadcast 3 to 4 bursts of the song, about 15 seconds. Then listen and watch for 2 minutes. Repeat this sequence for 6 minutes of survey at each point. The tape should be played at the volume of natural bird calls, not too loud to distort the vocalizations. If a willow flycatcher is detected, record the point number and whether this is the first, second, or third willow flycatcher. Refer to the written protocol for complete directions.
If when you're doing a survey, you have a bird that comes in and whits at you, but never fitzbues, you can't determine whether it's a willow flycatcher or not using our protocol. So what the protocol requires is if that happens to you, you have to go back to that site, to that location. You need to mark it on the map or the photo and go back to it after you finish the survey or on another morning within 5 days to try again to determine whether that bird you saw was in fact a willow flycatcher or a dusky flycatcher or something like that. So usually when you're going to do that, you want to go back into the same location, and the first thing you really want to do is just sit down and watch and listen and try to see if you see any, find the bird again and see if you can get it to fitzbue just first on its own. And then after about 20 minutes, it's a good idea to go through and play the tape, do the same, playing the tape, listen for 2 minutes, play the tape, listen for 2 minutes, and then basically go back to watching quietly and listening for a response. And it's usually a good idea to kind of give the bird a little distance and maybe try a couple different location watch to see if you can determine for sure whether you've got a willow flycatcher or not.
Many willow flycatchers have been banded through various research projects in California. Some birds have a unique color combination of small leg bands. If you detect a willow flycatcher with leg bands, try and determine if there is more than one leg band and what color the bands are. In some areas of the West, the brown-headed cowbird can significantly impact willow flycatcher populations through nest parasitism, which decreases or eliminates flycatcher productivity, nesting success, or juvenile survival. It is important to document cowbird occurrences. Observers should be familiar with and be able to identify cowbirds by sight and vocalizations. Let's listen to the vocalization of the brown-headed cowbird.
Fill in all appropriate information on willow flycatcher survey forms 1 and 2 while still in the field. Mark locations of detections on a USGS topographic map. Make a habit of reviewing the forms before you leave the site. Summarize survey information and willow flycatcher locations on Form 3. Complete all survey forms for each site, whether or not flycatchers were detected. Failure to survey all. Copy and submit all survey forms to the California Department.
Should use all. Become familiar with the morphology of the willow to get you started. For more in the Pacific Southwest Region Ecosystem Conservation Program, 7562-8737 at 760-376-3781 or by email at tbenson@fs.fed.us.